Hey guys, I got to sit down with Susan Eisenberg at Denver Comic-Con 2016 to talk about voice acting and her role as Wonder Woman in the Justice League animated shows. Enjoy! Hello, Susan Eisenberg. It is a huge pleasure to meet you.
Hi, how are you? So great to be here.
I'm great, and I'm glad you think that way. So, first question, how did you start your career in voice acting?
Well, when I was young, maybe a little older than you, I worked with my dad. He had a department store, and he would go to these radio shows weekly. And there would be just a bunch of people sitting around talking about weekly events, and then there would be an advertisement for his business. And I got to do the advertisement, and I liked it. And as I got older, and I went to college and studied acting, graduated, thought, I don't love being in front of a camera. I much prefer to be in front of a microphone. In front of a camera, I felt like self-conscious, and this didn't make me feel self-conscious. So I took classes, and I put together a demo reel, and I got an agent, and I auditioned, and I auditioned, and I auditioned, and I'm still auditioning.
So what's your favorite part about voice acting?
What's my favorite part about voicing?
Voice acting in general.
I love that you get to tell a story without this, without the face. Like, I love that it's through your voice that you're connecting to your audience. I like that you don't have to be concerned with vanity, because so much of the time it becomes about looks and this, and I have to be thin or fat or blah, blah, blah. And it's just like, it's here for you to create it in your voice. And obviously you use other pieces of yourself. It's not just your voice, but you start there. And I like that. It's freeing to me.
So what's the most memorable experience you've had because of voice acting? And why is that?
One of them is doing cons. I mean, it's because of what I got to do with voiceover. Because I got to voice Wonder Woman, I get to come to places like this and have people walk up to my table and tell me that they loved a TV show I did and that they love a character I voiced. And they're really touched by that. And that touches me because, when you're recording it, you just record it in a room and then you leave. So you don't really have the connection to the audience. And then social media came along, and Twitter and all this stuff, Instagram. And so now you're able to communicate with your audience. And then you come here and you get to meet people. So that has been a gift for me, and that voiceover gave me that.
What are your favorite perks of voice acting?
Perks? Mm-hmm. You don't have to dress up for a session. Mm-hmm. So that's fantastic. Like, literally, you know, if you're doing on camera, you know, you have to do your makeup and your hair and you have to look fab. And with voiceover, when I go to an audition, I mean, you know, I don't walk out of the house in sweatpants, but I could, because no one would care. So that's a perk. And you can also grow old with voiceover. No one's concerned about what, if this looks like it's 25 or 35 or 45 or 75. The voice changes, of course, it ages, but not that intensely. So do I sound like I sounded when I was 25? No. But do I sound so differently? Not at all. So I can grow old doing this. So that's a massive virtue.
I'll try to make this as quick and painless as possible.
Don't overestimate your abilities. My people are warriors, no less than yours.
How would you briefly describe voice acting for more famous shows? And what do you do because of that? Is there anything, like, different about it?
Well, so there's animation shows. And the ones that I've done, you go in and it's the entire cast is there. So that's phenomenal because you're working with Batman and, in my case, Batman and Flash and Martian Manhunter and Hawkgirl, and it's wonderful because we're all there. So we can all work off of each other and our energy is there, and it's fantastic. In a video game, when I've done the video games, you're usually by yourself. So you're in a booth by yourself. Now, the writer and the director and the engineer are on the other side, so you're with them, but it doesn't have the same feel to it. And you know, with the animation, you have a read through, you have a rehearsal. There's just something like, okay, we're putting on a show. Video games are feeling more and more technical. And then there's commercial work and promo work. And the promo is like you go into a booth, you say, you know, this week on the NFL, and you, you know, you do it quick, and then you're out. And commercial is like, you know, you're just selling a product on television. And you go in and there's an ad agency person. The writer is usually there. The client usually isn't there. But then they have to call into the client to play what you've done. So it's all different, but it's all fantastic if you get to do all of it.
Being more focused on what you're here for, being the voice actor of Wonder Woman for the Justice League, what kind of characteristics do you have for Wonder Woman and to make her the character she is? Or how do you make Wonder Woman different than something like Giganta or something like that?
Well, there are two pieces to it. So one is the voice, how she sounds, and one is who she is. And when I started the job, I was told by the creator of the show, Bruce Timm, he showed me what she looked like. He showed me a picture of her. And then I was also told by him and the director who she was. So that she's a princess and a warrior. And those two things can be very different, you know? And so incorporating that into a voice, that was what my challenge was. And when I would get too princess-like and not warrior enough, Andrea Romano, the director, would say, bring the warrior, remember the warrior, so that you're always being true to that character. She's regal, in my opinion. Diana is regal. So there's that when you're speaking like her. I always tried to bring some of that to it, to the performance. And then at the same time, she's tough as nails. And she won't ever back down from a fight, especially if justice if people are fighting for justice. And so she's so strong. And so you have to keep that. You know, you can't have the voice be little, because, you know, Amazons wouldn't have little voices. They have big voices. You know, I've got this, Superman. You know, they've got that. And then you have people helping you along the way. So you create something, you know, given what they've told you to do. And then they can tweak it and they can say a little of this, a little of that. Oh, remember this, remember that. But once you find the character, and I feel like I have found her, then it's a gift.
Don't you ever wish you were down there?
I'm down there all I need to be.
Yes, but it's just a job to you. I'm talking about going down there and having some fun. Maybe with someone special. No. No dating for the Batman. It might cut into your brooding time.
So, again, what's your favorite part of voice acting Wonder Woman, specifically?
That she's so extraordinary. Like, I love being able to give voice to this incarnation of her. I mean, there are other people, you know, there's Gal doing her in the movies, and Linda Carter did her in television. So, but this particular Wonder Woman, I feel like she was extraordinary, and I got to voice her for 6 years, and in the movies for a few years too. And I think it's a very lucky feeling when you get to voice somebody who's a hero. I mean, some people would prefer to play the villain. Maybe it's, you know, you can eat the scenery more. But I have always felt lucky that I get to play the heroine. And when she's really heroic, you know, that's when I most enjoy playing her.
And I should say, like,
I'm lucky that I voice a character that people know, that people line up to see. And, you know, that I auditioned for that in 2000. It's 2016, and here I am being interviewed by you because of that character. So it is, you know, that was a gift for me.
So, the topic of that, it is the 75th anniversary of Wonder Woman, and you were lucky enough to represent her in one of the coolest animated series ever. Why do you think Wonder Woman is so important, and why does she appeal to people so much, especially with young women like me?
I don't think there are a lot of female heroes for young girls to look up to. I think it's important that we create more. But she was an original, and she's been doing this for a long time, 75 years. There aren't that many other ones, I mean, that have been around that long, that women and girls all aspired to. Men love her, too. Men love her as this strong woman who stands up for herself and can stand toe-to-toe with Superman and Batman. And that's why she was created. And, you know, for me, it's a privilege that I get to honor her endurance in a small way, you know, by being here, just by spreading the word and meeting people who are fans and sharing with that. I mean, it's wonderful.
If you could have the chance to voice act for any character, what would it be?
Any character?
I am Diana, Princess of the Amazons. I won't be denied.
I don't know. The first thing that came to my mind was Cruella de Vil, because it's so far removed from what I've done, and it's so big, you know? And so, like, there's something about playing that kind of character, but then, like, I love puppies, and so that would be impossible. You know, some sort of zany witch-like character would be fun. Yeah. Do you have anything for me?
I don't know. I think there's a lot of different characters that you could be, because, like, a diverse of different characters. Mm-hmm. So, for me, in school last year, we had to describe what it would be like to be a student in my school in just a couple of words. I used words like exciting and repetitive. What does it feel like to be a voice actor in just a few words?
Well, I still get thrilled by it. You know, I remember walking in to do Justice League for the first time, and I was so scared. I mean, terrified scared. And it took me a long time to not be really scared. But I loved it so much. So I have such gratitude, because whether it's voiceover or anything, I'm pursuing what I love. I'm pursuing what I feel passionate about. It is competitive, it is hard to get jobs, all of those things. But I still pinch myself that I get to do this for a living, and that I'm making a living doing this, that I'm at Denver Comic Con talking to you. That, you know, that's gratitude. Absolutely.
So, I read that you had a new film that you're voice acting in coming out in a year or so. Is there anything you could tell us about that?
No. I wish I could, but there are two projects that are coming out next year, and I can't talk about either one of them, which is so hard, because I would love to be able, especially, you know, I could tell you right here, right now, but I'm not allowed to talk about any of it. But stay tuned is what I would say. And maybe we could do a follow-up interview once everything comes out.
Okay.
Okay?
And then, is there anything else we should know about you, Susan Eisenberg?
That I love Batman. Mm-hmm. But I think everyone knows that already. That I feel like a very, very, very lucky person. So, and, you know, that's primarily it. I feel like a lucky gal.
It was great talking with you. I had a lot of fun. You're a great person.
Thank you. Mm-hmm. I like talking with you, too. You know, when they said I had an interview, I didn't know it was with somebody under 40. And so I'm pleasantly surprised. This is the first interview I've done with somebody under 30. Mm-hmm. So thank you. Wonderful questions.
Thank you.
Did I miss anything?
Not really. The important thing is you're safe.
Yeah, of course. That's not the only important thing. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.